This is XPW TV. My name is Chris Kloss, and this is a company still in disarray just 2 weeks after Shane Douglas won the XPW world title. Shane and Lizzie right now are in control. The world of XPW is right in the palms of their hands. Now, since his loser leaves town world title match, Webb has not been seen or heard from, and for that matter, Rob Black hasn't either. And I, Chris Kloss, had just been handed my letter of relocation. That's right, XPW once again going to the East Coast on Smithfield Street in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the new XPW offices. Now, XPW TV will be airing in parts of Pennsylvania, Delaware, as well as New Jersey. And the show will be airing every Monday night at midnight. The show will be called XPW Monday Nightmare. Now, fans, stay tuned for more XPW action. We're going to see King of the Deathmatch title action. And coming up, the three-way war ladder match for the XPW World Television title.
Oh, there you are.
Black.
Hey, Miss Black.
Ben.
What, did you take the bed too?
Oh, man.
Sleeping on the floor.
This is it, man. This is like all I got. It's a bunch of films, man.
Yeah. A lot of films. A lot.
I can't believe what happened, man. I mean, everything was going good.
Yeah.
And let me tell you something, Webb. She's just sat back. She's gonna call me. She's gonna call the phone, baby. She's gonna call me. This is like a misunderstanding thing, you know? You know what I mean? You know how women are. You know, they get moody and stuff. And
nah, she ain't get a call back.
No, listen to me. All right, listen to me. She's gonna call back. I know, we've gone through a lot together. All right? She's gonna call back. It's just a misunderstanding, this whole Shane thing. I mean, it was, you know, it's just, you know, fooling everybody and stuff.
Nah, she ain't gonna call back. I don't think Little Juice Boy is gonna call back either.
Can you believe he did that? Can you believe Kevin was in on this plan the whole time?
Yeah.
How could he not have seen this?
Medication. You know, he had the problems and stuff. Speaking of which, you need any stuff, you know, because I got some stuff. They tried to blow me up. This stuff's pretty good.
What do you got?
I don't know what it does, but pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, I thought things was kind of funny, you know, with the whole Terry Funk thing, you know, and you weren't really all in control at the time, you know. And it was like a Kleinrock operation. So I got a little, you know, kind of...
You didn't know.
I kind of sensed something weird. A little bit.
Everything's weird to you. You didn't know. If you would have known, you would have told me. Yeah, if you'd known, you would have told me. I would still be here with Lizzie, and you would still be the champion.
Yeah, that's true. But, I don't know, it's kind of nice not being the hunted anymore, you know? I can be the hunter.
Damn.
You know?
I don't know what I'm going to do. I need to go see my lawyer Tuesday.
So let me ask you something. Do I have to actually, like, leave town? Like, do I have to, like, go to, like Florida or something like that, or like how far is town? Loser leaves town. How far is that?
Well, I think it's like California.
I gotta leave California.
Yeah.
Huh.
Maybe just San Bernardino.
Huh.
You still got that trailer up there, don't you?
Uh-uh.
Where's the trailer now?
It's gone. Didn't need it anymore, you know? Had all the nice stuff, you know? Tab. put all the nice stuff on the tab, you know, so I didn't need all that old crap, so I got rid of all the old crap and just gave it away.
You know, I got
the king used to give things away all the time, you know.
I gotta be honest with you about something.
What's that?
Okay, you know, like that whole tab thing?
Yeah.
There was never really like a tab. Like, you never really owed me money. You know, I just said that. You know? I just said you owed me money. Well, I took your money. You know, I just, you know.
Oh, you saved it. Saved my money.
No.
You didn't save my money.
No.
Oh. There's no tab.
There's no money.
So.
There's no Lizzie.
So, if you had money, you would, like, owe me money. But you don't have any money. So, the money that you owe me, I ain't gonna get.
Yeah, something like that.
Oh. That's fine.
I thought you'd understand. But...
you know, it was fun while it lasted, as they say.
Damn.
It didn't ring. It's the crickets. Yeah, crickets out there. It's up the phone.
I mean, a divorce. You know, we live in California. Like, she could take, like, all my...
Yeah, at least
because I got everything when we were together.
And yeah,
like,
yeah.
I acquired, like, Extreme and XPW when we were together. So she could get, like, all my...
Yeah, you're a...
She's not gonna. She's not leaving me, man. It's a misunderstanding.
Nah, she left.
She didn't leave.
Yeah, she's with their franchise.
When Sandman, aided by the Enterprise, beat Supreme at Freefall to become the XPW King of the Deathmatch, well, to say the least, Supreme was enraged. He tracked the Sandman down in Cleveland, Ohio, broke his ankle, actually stole the belt, and then, at Liberty or Death, he demanded that the third annual XPW King of the Deathmatch tournament would be held to determine the new champion. And of Night of Champions, XPW did just that. And look at this now, both men going at it. The opening match in the first round. And look at this. Oh my God. You better watch yourself, Fantastico. You got to cover up. I mean, there's weapons all around the ringside area.
Wait a minute. I think they put our chair in the wrong place today, man.
I think
man.
They did. Look at this.
We're right up on the action here. This ain't right.
Sandman. Yes. Oh. Did you hear the impact? Did you hear the impact?
Right away, starting with the hardcore. Unbelievable. Here comes Sandman in our direction. Watch out.
And look at this. Right in front of us.
Kloss, you better be ready to move.
I am. I'm covering up. There's going to be blood spraying everywhere. Oh, look at this, right between the eyes. Look at that. Well, you call them one of those bamboo tiki torches, if you will.
Yeah, but you know what? It's sharpened at the tip, and it can do lots of damage. Look at that.
Look at that. Already cut wide open. Supreme busted open. The Sandman taking control, taking charge against the man that won the first ever XPW King of the Deathmatch tournament.
Now, remember, Chris, the history between these two? Supreme. Going all the way down to Cleveland to steal the belt away from...
Oh!
Unbelievable blow right there. Supreme stole the belt from Sandman, left him with a broken ankle. Sandman is angry, and I'm sure he wants to avenge the injury.
And you can't blame him for his anger, because Supreme... Oh, look at this! Look at this! The thumbtacks! Oh, this is sick, Wantastico! This is sick!
I have no idea what possessed Rob Black to... I have no idea what possessed Rob Black to do another deathmatch tournament, but you know what? If the first match is any indication of what the rest of the night is going to be like, we're in for a hell of a night.
And look at this now, the trash can on the head of Supreme and the flat nose shovel right to the trash can that was just draped right over the head of Supreme. And Supreme really taking a beating now from the Sandman here in the first round, the first match of the first round. Blow right to the head now. Look at that, hovering right over that light bulb. And what is this? A little, oh no, thumbtack paintbrush.
It's a thumbtack paint roller, that's right, Chris, watch out.
Sending now the original King of the Deathmatch into the ring. The Sandman going, oh, look at this, right on the face of Supreme. This is sick, Wantastico.
Niños, por favor, leave the room. Leave the room. This is very graphic. Not for your eyes.
And I noticed one task ago, you didn't join yourself in this tournament.
You know what? By the time I even heard about it. By the time I even heard about the deathmatch tournament, it was all booked up. There was nothing I could do.
Yeah, right. I've heard it all before. And look at this. Look at the blood just pouring all out. And now it's Supreme. Supreme is fighting back. Forearms to the head of the Sandman. The Sandman now staggering across the ropes. Clothesline. Nope, duck underneath the Sandman with a clothesline of his own. And Supreme goes crashing down. And you can hear the fans' disapproval of the Sandman. The fans really not taking a liking to this guy in this packed house tonight at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. Thousands on hand for the third annual King of the Deathmatch Tournament and some other tournaments going on tonight. I can't remember.
Well, that'll be the tag team title tournament, Kaos.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
The finals, as we see Supreme's eyes being raked across that barbed wire.
Right now, the Sandman taking a little bit too much time, if you ask me. Look at this. What has he got now in hand? The Sandman with a shot, forearm shot. Fist right to the head, but no. Supreme blocking, and then once again, Supreme is fighting back, Montasico. Supreme knows what it's like to be the king of the deathmatch, and he wants to win this tournament more than anybody, I believe.
I believe Supreme was born. He feels he was born to be the king of the deathmatch, the champion of the deathmatch, and he has proved it over again.
No, the bed of nails being utilized, but no, Sandman. With an elbow to the midsection, countering now, Supreme. Supreme staggering back. And look at this now, Supreme thrown, yes, to the outside of the ring. And you gotta watch out. Once again, they're right in front of us. They are right in front of us. No, what is this? A little blow-up doll? Looks like GQ Money.
Looks like a GQ Money piñata, man. Look at that.
I never thought I'd see GQ Money smaller than what he is.
You know what, you got a point there. I have to agree with you.
These light bulbs all around the ringside area, all the weaponry. And now, once again, both men inside of the ring. Irish whip coming up, reversal from Supreme. Oh, no, look at that. Trips him right in the middle of the ring. Beautiful move from Supreme.
That was a wrestling move that came out of nowhere, Kloss. He reversed the Irish whip and dropped to a toehold immediately.
Absolutely. And now it's another Irish whip coming up. Now another reversal from Supreme. Look at this. Step over toehold and head first into the steel garbage can.
Well, this time it was Sandman's turn to feel that trash can. I mean, Supreme got a face full of that earlier with a bat. This time, the Sandman got a face full of it. Flash.
And now look at this. It's that mini GQ Mini Money. Excuse me, Money.
Mini GQ Mini?
I never thought I'd see anything smaller than the real GQ Money, but the artificial GQ Money is much smaller. And look at this. The face being just raked across that bed of nails. And look at the face of the Sandman as he's busted wide open.
Now we have two bloody bastards in the ring.
Two bloody, whoa. And now look at this. Once again, Supreme with the Sandman. Just right where he wants him. Another Irish whip coming up. Grab chest. Scoop up. Power slam. Oh, did you see that? The impact, Montastico.
You know what? All I have to say is I wish that the guy that got slammed, I wish that was a real GQ Money. I would have eliminated a bunch of our problems right off the bat right there.
Of course, the main event, that's a different story altogether. But look at this, Supreme going to the top rope. Supreme.
And look, Sandman can't kick out.
Look at this, mega toad splash, yes!
Oh!
One, two, it's over! Supreme advances in the tournament. And the Sandman is gone, eliminated. Supreme advances in the King of the Deathmatch tournament. Unbelievable, unbelievable.
Devil's
So Supreme advanced in the tournament and the Sandman officially lost his XPW King of the Deathmatch title. Now certainly the first ever XPW Deathmatch King was the odds on favorite to win the entire tournament, but what an upset it would be. What a name somebody could make for themselves if they were to advance and beat Supreme. Now, in the match between Vinny Massaro and Ultra Boy Luke, one of these men would have their chance. The winner would advance to the semifinals to go against Supreme.
It's Vinny Massaro. And this guy is a surprise entry as far as I'm concerned for the Deathmatch Tournament. But we're going to see what he's made of tonight.
Well, let me tell you something about the Soprano guy over here. I got nothing
it's
against
Massaro.
The Black Army.
Massaro.
Whatever his name is, all right? Let me tell you something. I got nothing against the Black Army, but this guy right here, he learned in the ring. You see that? He learned in the ring that you can't mess with Pogo the Clown and Juan Tástico. That is why Vinny Massaro was forced to enter the Deathmatch Tournament while Pogo and I are still in the Tag Team Tournament. How do you like that? That's what I thought, Vinny.
Still the weapons all over the place, Juan Tástico. And yes, the Altar Boy.
Luke.
One half of the Altar Boy, Luke.
I believe this is Luke.
I believe it is as well. Look at the eyes.
He believes himself to be very, very righteous.
Indeed. Last time I saw him here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena, I thought I was at a Benny Hinn Revival concert.
At a what?
A Benny Hinn. You know, Paul and Chan, TBN, never mind. This guy has been preaching all over the world.
Introducing first, originally from Sicily, Italy, now residing in Las Vegas, Nevada, here is Sicily's favorite son, Vinny Massaro.
Vinny Massaro now being introduced.
And what Italians do you know with blonde hair?
His opponent from
not
the St. Mark's Cathedral, here is Altar Boy Luke.
You know, you got to be really careful with these Altar Boys in the background in the locker room over there, because, man, if they corner you, they will start preaching your ear off.
Well, they try to convert you.
They really do. I mean, I saw one of these guys talking to Kleinrock. He wasn't having it, though.
And look at this now, the second match of the first round. Armbringer now, from Luke now, onto Vinny Massaro. And then look at this, a reversal from Vinny Massaro into an armbar. And now look at this, snapper takeover, no, up and over, yes. Luke of the Altar Boys, leapfrog, up and over, off the ropes now, no. Oh, look at this, back body drop, no. Reversed into a leg scissor, Hurricane Rana, and a beautiful takedown from Luke onto Vinny Massaro. Irish whip coming up, reversal now, from Massaro. To the far side, look at this, up and over, reverse DDT, beautifully executed from Luke. And these Altar Boys had shown me so much just in their last appearance here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
Unbelievable, these Altar Boys, watch this, innovative maneuver.
Oh, well, look at that, beautiful moonsault. One, two, only two.
From the outside in, I might add, never have I seen that before.
Beautiful standing dropkick from Luke of the Altar Boys. And this doesn't look like a death match so far, does it, Juan Tástico?
Not at all, but at any moment, the tide could turn. Shades of Rey Mysterio there.
Luke of the Altar Boys. Vinny Massaro now taking the low road out, it looks like.
And the Altar Boy giving a blessing to the people chanting his name right here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena as Vinny Massaro's on the apron. Oh, very smart move. Veteran move by Vinny Massaro.
Luke was going to use the leverage, pulling Massaro back in with that top rope, but it was Massaro quick on his feet. Look at this tornado spin of a... Oh, what a clothesline that was from Vinny Massaro. Just leveled Luke.
Shades of Pogo the Clown there.
Shades of Pogo indeed. We're going to be seeing a little bit later on in the XPW World Tag Team Title Tournament here tonight at Night of the Champions. And what a night this is going to be. What a night it's been so far. Belly to back suplex beautifully executed from Vinny Massaro. And look at this, another one. Look at this, two right in a row. You got to be kidding me. a percivalous amount of belly-to-back suplexes. Yes, three. No, oh, into a facebuster.
Wow, Vinny Massaro with a plethora of maneuvers to take out the Ultra Boy Luke.
And this is very reminiscent of a classic XPW match, but it's not reminiscent yet so far at all of a death match. A tremendous match so far. Look at this, Luke. Once again, getting out top of the sleeper hold, trying to keep Massaro in the center of the ring.
You know what? Very smart move. Very smart move by a small guy.
Oh, sidewalk slam.
Wow, I was about to say that it was a very smart move for the smaller guy to try to knock the bigger guy off his feet with a sleeper hold. Massaro, though, the veteran that he is, turning it around into a sidewalk slam.
Beautifully executed from the man from Sicily, Italy. And now it's Massaro with the upper hand. Oh, no, look at this. The bed of nails. No. Counter from Luke. Fist now to the head of Vinny Massaro. Irish whip coming up. Yes. Reversal from Massaro. Look at this. No, clothesline. Duck underneath. And look at the speed of Luke. Oh, look at this. Going to. Yes. Another leg super. Hurricane Rana. And you can hear the approval of the fans here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
The fans really
Oh, into the bed of nails. Drop kick again. And he went crashing again. Massaro did. Look at this, Luke. Did you see the impact?
Vinny face first after the impact into the bed of nails. Unbelievable.
Going for the pin now. Luke, one, two, only two. That was close.
These two guys putting on a beautiful, beautiful match. It is a death match, even though we haven't seen too much of the death match tools implemented, but still a beautiful match nonetheless.
Look at this, Irish whip once again coming up. No, a beautiful baseball slide stop. Oh, look at this. Double clothesline. None at all. Oh, my goodness. Did you see that suplex right into the bed of barbed wire?
His lower back and legs crashing into that barbed wire. Unbelievable. The Ultra Boy taking punishment. I don't know how Luke better pray for an escape
and
here.
This could be it right here. One, two. Oh, how did he kick out of that? After that double underhook suplex into the bed of barbed wire.
It must have been a miracle.
Well,
he must have been a miracle, Chris.
Do you really think that these guys
was
have
always
the power
praying?
That...
What is this? Wait.
Oh, ooh. Kick to the midsection now. Counter from Luke and the Altar Boys. Off the ropes. Clothesline. No, look at this. Double under. Oh!
I heard about this. That's a move. That's his move now. Vinny's other move. That's called the forget about it right there.
That's the forget about it.
Forget about
that's
it.
That's it right there. And forget about it. Because, oh my goodness. How did he kick out of it?
Vinny's in shock. Vinny's in shock.
So am I. So am I.
That was it. That was a forget about it.
I've never seen the forget about it executed ever. And he executed it beautifully. Now it looks like he's going for the belly to back. No. Look at this. And it's Luke with the counter. And these fans taking a huge like neck breaker. Luke now getting Massaro right where he wants him. Luke going upstairs. What do we have in mind here? Moonsault perhaps coming up. Twisting moonsault. Yes, it's over.
I think that's an upset.
Luke advancing in the tournament. Unbelievable. Over Vinny Massaro.
That's an upset.
So Altar Boy Luke, with a very impressive first time outing in tag team competition at Liberty or Death, follows up with another impressive singles debut match. Now, when we return, fans, we're going to take you back to the three-way ladder war as Kaos defends the title against Confederate currency Chris Hamrick in Psicosis.
How the hell is there a cricket in here?
Yeah, crickets.
Did I tell you I gotta see a lawyer Tuesday?
You can afford a lawyer, sir?
Yeah.
Still got a little couple of nickels to rub together?
Yeah.
You know, you really should save your money, you know? Because I know this guy, you know, he's kind of like a couple blocks down. I don't know if I told you about him before, Law Dogs, you know? It's like a hot dog stand, but on Wednesdays, like at 7 p.m., they give you free legal advice. We can go talk to him. You know, that's free. You know, you can't be free.
All right.
Yeah, you know.
All right, set that up.
Legal advice, chili dog.
can't believe you're not the champion anymore. Can't believe Shane Douglas has Lizzie. I wish you could get the title back. I can get Lizzie back.
Yeah. Well, I guess you can't be wrestling for no XPW no more.
This sucks.
Yeah, it does suck. But, I don't know, man. Maybe my, maybe I can get my knee finally fixed, you know?
Dude. It's her.
You think?
Dude, I know it's her. Hey, baby. Who's this? What? Angel! It's an angel!
You an angel?
Not me an angel! Angel! How you doing? How's your back? You alright? I'm not doing good.
Tell him Webb says hey.
Webb says hey, man. Yeah, we're just kicking it back here. Alright, man. Why am I talking to you, man?
Yeah, she ain't gonna call back. I don't think.
Didn't even get a chance. What? Someone there? Someone there? Come in. Who? Wait. No, don't come in. Who is it? Oh, cowboy.
Money.
Superstar.
Look
superstar.
At you now,
brother.
All
brother.
Dressed up in your pretty stripes and shirt. Your beautiful makeup. But where were you, United Champions, for me? I went out there by myself. We're supposed to be the Enterprise, simply the best mouth of the West. Where were you? You didn't even back me up. You got beat by the hardcore homo.
Brother, listen up.
How many times are you gonna get beat by the hardcore homo? And then you and Veronica came with this elaborate plan. You knew all along, my double gold, my destiny.
Double gold, brother.
You make me look like a fool, go out there, and you give the shot to that old piece of Shane Douglas?
I had nothing to do with it, brother.
Oh, you know, you can't. You know, I came here to tell you one thing. I came here to tell you to go yourself.
Do you go?
The sting? For that sting?
Go myself?
Yeah. Nothing.
Brother,
supposed to be part of
you. You got it all wrong, brother. Listen up.
All
you gotta
the
understand.
Ways.
No, you gotta understand, brother. I had nothing to do with this. Sure, I got knocked out. Brother, I got thrown off through a flaming table. It was a flaming table. It was kind of
and
a flaming.
And you missed the table.
But my head clipped the car, brother. And I had a subdermal hematoma, brother.
A what?
A subdermal hematoma, brother.
What?
A subdermal hematoma, brother. I thought I wasn't going to make it. I swear to God, I did it. Brother, I would have been out there.
Wait. What?
Brother, I would have been loyal to you. I would be loyal to you. I am loyal to you. We will go and we will get the double gold. We will first blow by that Southern hick wannabe money man Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick, brother. We will destroy him. We will annihilate him. We will take him down and out. You will climb the ladder rung by rung and prove your superiority around this country as professional wrestling's number one professional wrestler, brother, because you are the rock superstar. We are headed on the bigger and better things, brother. Forget about the past. And let's move into the future, because we're going to Philadelphia, brother, the house of hardcore, where you're going to prove yourself to be the elite, where I'm going to be in your corner, and we will get that chance, brother. We will get that chance for you to get your double gold. We will get our revenge on Lizzie Borden, Shane Douglas, Rob Black, whoever it may be, and we will prove ourselves to be the best, brother. And to prove my loyalty to you, because I won't let you down once more. I won't let you down again, brother. Let me hop up here, because I'm going to do something for you, my friend. I'm going to do something that I could only do. You see this thing right there? You see this, brother? You see this? This is your mark, your emblem, the mark of the rock superstar. And we're going to Philadelphia to prove that we are the true superstars of this game, brother. Oh, yeah. This is for you! Ah!
going on. I can't believe we're in this hotel. They say it's a 4-star, but it's more like a 1-star. I mean, the water made me itch. Shane's in the shower right now. He said it's fine, but... No. We'll be out here like in a week. Maybe we can help. We're having the house built. Yeah. Yeah, he's letting me build the house the way I want it, not the way Robert wanted it. Robert, I haven't seen him. I haven't heard of him. I haven't seen anything. Last I knew, Rob was in the room all bloody. Yeah. Everything's going great. Shane's great. Ugh, my phone's starting to break up. Okay, yeah, I guess I'm ready. Yeah, I see my lawyer's asleep. Uh-huh. No, we're taking everything. He's not getting anything. I've been through so much with him. Yeah. I'm taking XPW. I'm taking all the money. I'm even going to get extreme. I don't know where he's going to be. Who? That guy is so old. No. He's not going to our arena. It's our arena. Shane won't kill him. Terry Funk is old, beat up, tired, done with. No. No, not even lying at all. There's no way. You saw him. He could barely walk. He was in a wheelchair. No, don't even worry about it. Shane will kill him. There's no way Terry Funk could ever do anything to Shane. Shane's gonna kill Terry Funk, even if he shows up. He won't even show up. He's scared. Look, I gotta go. I gotta go tell Shane because he's gonna just... Yeah, he's gonna laugh. This is too funny. I gotta go. I'll talk to you later. Bye. Whatever. Terry Funk. Shane, you're never gonna believe this. Oh my god.
Ladies and gentlemen, Saturday night, August the 31st, XPW makes its East Coast debut from Viking Hall as Viking Hall gets extreme once again. And rumors been circulating, a buzz in the air, if you will, that Terry Funk will be making his way to Viking Hall on Saturday night, August the 31st, because he apparently wants a shot at Shane Douglas's XPW World Heavyweight title. Now, Saturday night, August the 31st, XPW presents Hostile Takeover. Tickets are available right now. You can call them up. The XPW box office. This is toll-free, ladies and gentlemen. 1-866-888-4336. Or you can go to xpwrestling.com. And ladies and gentlemen, if you're one of the many LA area fans heading on the old plane, back to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania for the big one Saturday night, August the 31st, live from Viking Hall. Be sure to let us know when you order tickets because you're all going to be admitted to a very special pre-show autograph session as XPW's way of saying thank you, Los Angeles. XPW, August the 31st, Viking Hall, XPW presents Hostile Takeover.
The wrestler who can climb the ladder and take possession of the belt high above the ring will be declared the XPW World Television Champion.
The TV title is on the line. As Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick makes his way to the ring. The man who very easily could have walked out of the Pico Rivera Sports Arena last month with the gold around his waist until that near fatal blow as the landmine just nearly killed, and I do mean killed, fans, Lizzie Borden. It was close, but Kaos was able to distract Chris Hamrick as Hamrick was distracted with a bomb going out of Lizzie Borden, Kaos getting the victory. And wait a minute, what is this? Psicosis now, coming to the ring. Psicosis could walk out of here as the television champion. Look at this, the TV title hanging high above the rafters. And here comes the champion, Kaos. There he is, the XPW TV champ, Kaos. And he looks naked without that belt around his waist. Of course, the belt hanging high above the scaffold. The 40-foot-high scaffold here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. And whoever captures that belt will be declared the undisputed XPW television champion. A packed house here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena. It's Kaos showing his stuff, the TV champ.
Introducing first challenger number one from Bristol, Tennessee, Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick.
Chris Hamrick now. Getting quite the ovation
challenger
here.
Number two from Tijuana, Mexico, Psicosis. And from Hollywood, California, representing the Enterprise, he is the current reigning and defending XPW World Television Champion. Here is the Rock Superstar, Kaos.
This is going to be a three-way war. The first man to capture the XPW TV title hanging high above the scaffold will be declared the undisputed XPW World Television Champion. What a battle this should be, and what a match that was last month between one-on-one Kaos and Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick. These two have quite a history together. They're barking at one another, and Psicosis is just laughing at it.
All three of these men with a surprising amount of experience, maybe over 30 years of wrestling experience. The man with the least amount, but the man, the odds-on favorite, the champ, the Rock Superstar Kaos. And he's got two of the finest contenders in the industry today. Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick, and Psicosis.
Armbar now, arm ringer from Kaos, and now a reversal from Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick. Somersault counter now from Kaos, another arm ringer of his own. And now look at it, oh, look at Psicosis just sneaking into the ring. Now these two are going at it. Look at this springboard. And look at this, Japanese arm drag. Another arm drag from Kaos on a Confederate Currency, a counter now from Currency, and now it's Kaos with one of his own. And these two match up very beautifully together.
The fans very appreciative, as is Psicosis, who's sitting back and letting these two athletes go at it.
Well, because these two athletes definitely have a history, snap mare and an elbow drop miss. But it's Psicosis missing again, all three men missing. Look at this Confederate Currency, another arm drag. Another arm drag now from Kaos on to Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick. And now look at this, it's Psicosis with an arm drag. And all three of these men showing what they're made of. And they're all gunning for the XPW TV title.
Chris Hamrick has come so close on several different occasions to getting that XPW World Television Championship. Kid Kaos still the only man undefeated as the XPW World Television Champion. Chris Hamrick so close, Chris Kloss, as is Psicosis. Will tonight be the night? Will the night of champions be a night that will be remembered as the night Kaos suffered his loss?
You're a lonely man, aren't you?
Very lonely.
And look at this now. Oh, Psicosis shoved. He was trying to set the ladder while these two guys were fighting to get the title. But look at this, Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick going right after Kaos. And this could be both these men's weakness. Huge clothesline from Psicosis as Kaos goes down. I mean, Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick, and Kiss. Look at that baseball sliding dropkick from Currency onto Kaos. The TV title is on the line. The TV title is hanging above, high above by the scaffold. Oh my gosh, look at this. Psicosis, high cross body on top of both Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick, and the TV champ, Kaos.
Over the top turnbuckle, the ladder, and the ring post, all the way onto the floor. All three of these men down. It could go any way right now. Chris Kaos is in a little bit more trouble than he may have anticipated here. Without the presence of Veronica King, without the presence of GQ Money, the Rock Superstar Kaos has to do it alone here tonight.
Irish whip reversal from Chris Hamrick. Look at this. Body scissors now. Oh, no. Current counter from Currency into a facebuster right on top of Psicosis.
And this match, pinfalls will not count. You have to retrieve the ladder. You can use it as a weapon, but you need to retrieve the ladder.
And look at this reverse Boston Crab counter into a surfboard-type maneuver.
Yes, look at this.
Send him into the Kyoko Inoue swing set, Psicosis. A submission doesn't count, and a reverse atomic knee drop now. Grapevines the leg.
Look at this now. Look at this, double submission. And look at this, tapping out. But tap outs do not count. Exactly right, Roundhead. Look at this, beautiful heel kick from Hamrick onto Kaos.
You can tap till the cows come home. You could say uncle all night, but the main objective is to grab that ladder and get that all-important World Television Championship belt.
Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick now with both men down, right where he wants them. Look at this, currency measuring. I don't know who he's taking a little risk but himself right now. Sitting on the top rope, trying to gain some composure himself. Double axe handle as Kaos goes down. Currency measured him beautifully, and now once again Chris Hamrick from the top drops the elbow. No, Kaos just barely, and I mean barely, run head moved out of the way. Now it's Kaos trying to capitalize.
Even without the Enterprise in his corner, Kaos is still wise enough, able to muster up the energy and the smartness. That time a full body slam on Kaos, by Kaos on Psicosis.
Look at this now, springboard moonsault, landing right on top.
Down.
Right on top of Psicosis. Psicosis suffering now, and currency laying flat on his back, perhaps getting a rest but himself. And now look at this, into the far side. Oh, what a kick that was. Right to the jaw, right to the face of Kaos. And now look at this possible tornado DDT coming up from the second rope. Yes, it's, oh no, but it's Kaos reversing it. Look at this, Hamrick. Hamrick now, both men, Hamrick. Oh,
incredible double team maneuver that
into
time.
Into a stunner.
Chris Hamrick nailing the stunner out of a tornado DDT attempt. Chris Hamrick needs to capitalize on the situation. He needs to get that ladder. He needs to climb it and get the belt. He needs to do it now.
Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick. He's got the advantage now. And look at this now. Both Psicosis and Kaos going at it. And this could, you could be right.
The pace that these athletes are going, 1,500 miles an hour.
Look at this now, Kaos. Oh, oh my gosh, make a wish. Oh!
Kaos again, the scrotum. The testicles right into the steel post. Doesn't feel good, Klaus. Take it from me.
Look at this now. Once again, Ron had a very lonely man. Irish whip boot to the midsection from Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick on the Psicosis. Oh no, it was a powerbomb attempt from Confederate currency. Chris Hamrick reversed into a facebuster from Psicosis, and now Psicosis, yes, Psicosis is going for the ladder. Psicosis will be going, looks like very shortly, the XPW TV title. Now where is he going?
Going,
he's grabbing
the
a chair.
Row.
Look at this, from one of the ringsiders. Psicosis.
The Rock superstar, the champion, is in trouble.
Oh no, oh no, you have got to be kidding me. Look at where he just perched that ladder. No, and he's got that chair. Ah! Confederate currency with that ladder right between his legs.
And Kaos going face first into the legs of the ladder. Psicosis better capitalize on this advantage. He needs to capitalize.
What an opportunity he has right now, Ronhead, to grab, to capture, to hold the undisputed XPW Television Championship belt. But no, look at this. He's going right after Kaos once again. I don't know if this is a very smart game plan right here on the part of Psicosis, Ronhead. However,
decapitate, drawn, dismember, he's trying to that ladder.
He's trying to send a message to both men. He's trying to send a message to everybody here at XPW that he means business. Oh no!
How much abuse can the Rock superstar take?
And look at the face! Look at the blood just spewing out of the head, out of the eyes, out of everywhere from Kaos. Oh, look at that! What a reversal that was! Desperation.
Slide kick into the ladder again, into the sack of Kaos.
Enziguri kick.
Enziguri into the head. Yakuza kick now into the head of Psicosis. Chris Hamrick, Confederate currency, trying to do it again to slow the man down as Kaos is down. The fans counting. 10 times into the face of El Nicho. Psicosis is in trouble. Kaos still staggered. Chris Hamrick, he needs to do something. Do it soon if he wants to be champion. That ladder now perpendicular, parallel with the body of Psicosis.
Look at this now. And once again, the ladder in between Psicosis and Kaos. But it's Chris Hamrick with the advantage right now, looking for something.
Making a ladder sandwich right now. Another, a double decker, another 20 plus foot ladder is being introduced. The blood is flowing like Niagara Falls.
And Ron Head, this is ridiculous. This is nuts. This is looks like this has turned into a death match. This was only the match for the XPW television title. And look at this, Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick. You've got to be kidding me. Look at the distance. Look at this.
All beef patty sandwich between two ladders.
Springboard. And he nails both men. Both ladders go crashing, but all three men are down.
20 plus feet across the ring.
And look at the blood. Look at that.
Blood everywhere. It's flowing out of the head. The champion is in so much trouble. It can be anyone's game right now.
This match can go either way. Any of three different ways. Kaos, Psicosis, Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick all gunning for the XPW World Television title. But the champion is to his feet first. And he's got the extra tall ladder. And look at this. Is he setting it up? Is he going to go for the title belt right now? He's looking up.
What a match. What a war we're seeing these men put themselves through. The abuse they submit their bodies to climb the ladder and get that all-important XPW World Television Championship. And it looks like
Kaos. And there it is. There it is right there.
That precious title,
yes.
That's almost always around the waist of the Rock superstar Kaos, hanging precariously.
Usually his security blanket, if you will.
A security blanket is one thing, but that thing is tattooed around the waist. He was kicking and screaming to have that title belt perched above the ring, and he's about to get it back now. He's going to retain that championship in a matter of
seconds. Ron Head, I think you're wrong. For the thousandth time in your life, I think you're wrong. Look at this. Kaos.
Maybe
what is he thinking?
Point,
oh,
what's
no.
he doing?
Moonsault from the ladder. No. Oh, and he missed. Did you see the elevation? Did you see the elevation?
Incredible damn hang time we're seeing there. Nobody home. The Rock superstar Kaos may have injured himself, and now El Nicho Psicosis now dropping the ladder, and we might see a new champion. We might see a man who can take that title back to Mexico. Psicosis inches away.
And I don't even understand how Kaos is walking, but yes, Ron Head, look at this. Inches, centimeters, millimeters away from the belt. Yeah, look at this. There it is. But no, Confederate currency on his feet. Oh, no. Look at this. The ladder teetering. Oh! Clothesline right on top of that top rope.
And that may have knocked Psicosis out. That may have knocked the man out. He's not moving as that top rope steel cable may have taken the face and sliced it off of Psicosis.
Taking the life out of Psicosis.
That is a lifeless body right there. Now a chair.
Oh, look at that, right to the small of the back. Kaos swung that chair with all his might that he has right now. Very winded in this match. A lot has been taken out of all three men. However, there's still, the heart is in this. All three men are still gunning for the XPW TV title. And you can see a lot has been taken out of Kaos. Literally, look at the blood flowing down his face, Ron Head.
The blood. The energy, but one thing that is not taken away is the determination, the sheer guts. And I hate to give the man credit, but that man has more guts.
Oh, what a chop! What a chop that was from Psicosis!
Don't count the challengers out, however.
Oh, shoulder first to the near side of ring number two.
Into the post, the shoulder right into the post. Psicosis has had shoulder problems over the years. That's not going to help his matter any. Now two ladders. Both ladders in stereo now being perched up. It can be
Kaos.
Any game.
Kaos climbing the wrong side of the ladder, but it looks like he doesn't give a damn.
I tell you, whoever wins this match, the other two men will have nothing to be ashamed of, as this may be the most physical, maybe one of the greatest.
And look at this. It's a race for the title. Kaos and Hamrick both going up.
Looks like Kaos has it.
No, he just batted it away now. He's going after, look at Psicosis going after Confederate currency on the other ladder.
Kaos now kicked off. Both Kaos
kicking off Psicosis Kaos.
Look at this, the title! The title! Both men have it!
They both have their hands on the belt! They both have their grasp on the title!
And they're both hanging from the chain, Psicosis! No, you gotta be kidding me, he's taking the ladder out from both of them!
Psicosis has taken one ladder! Both men hanging on for dear life,
and
hanging
under the
chain,
ladder.
They're hanging up on the ring!
They're hanging from the raptor on the chain, Psicosis going up! Psicosis going up! How long can these men hang?
The ladder now almost taken away from them. Who's going to get the title belt? And now, again, they're hanging up. The fans going berserk. They're
and look at referee Patrick Hernandez. Oh, my goodness. Psicosis hanging from the legs. And can this chain hold?
Down goes Psicosis.
Down goes Psicosis and down goes the ladder, perhaps. This ladder teetering in the middle of the ring. Oh, my.
What the hell?
What the hell just happened? What's the verdict? What is the verdict? And where's the title?
All three men are down. The championship belt's down.
Wait a minute. The first time in the history of a ladder match. And look how confused referee Hernandez is. But what's the official word? We're on head going to the ring right now. Hopefully we can shed some light on the subject. What? Apparently, Kaos retains the title! Well, Psicosis is obviously not the winner. It's either Kaos or Confederate currency, Chris Hamrick. But Kaos leaving with the title.
Patrick Hernandez declaring this match a no contest. Still, XPW World Television Champion, The Rock Superstar, Kaos.
Well, there you have it, fans. A no contest, a no decision, as Kaos will still walk out of here with the XPW television title, I mean currency, and both Kaos, both with their hands on the title, falling to the ground at the exact same time. That has never happened before in the history of a ladder match. However, Kaos walks out of here with the gold, a no contest.
I guess we're doing intermission now. Is that it? Are any other ones besides the two others? No, I don't have a reason.
To you, and now it's time you take the ultimate step, the ultimate leap, and you prove yourself to be brothers with me as you burn the symbol into your leg, brother. And we take it. Let me get this going, brother, because this one is all about being the superstar that you are, that we are, the shining star, the superstar, the supernova, the super quasar. Oh, brother, you gotta grab it. You gotta take hold. You gotta stick it through and feel it, baby. Cause it's the burn that it takes, the passion it takes, the desire to withhold the fire within and become the very best, brother.
Oh, yeah.
Unleash the wrath that is that of the Rock Superstar. Unleash what will be the greatest phenomenon in that that is professional wrestling. This will be the day, and that will be the night, because it's time to solidify ourselves.
Simply the best, mouth the West.
Ah!
Right on?
Right on, brother. Right, right?
Right, right.
Right, right.
Right, right, right. So Kaos retains the XPW TV title, albeit in a huge cloud of controversy. Now this marks three different occasions that the TV champ just slid by Chris Hamrick. However, I've just been informed that on Saturday night, August the 31st, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, in the XPW arena, The final rematch ladder match for the XPW television title will take place as Kaos one final time will defend against Confederate Currency, Chris Hamrick. Fans, this is all the time we have this week. I want to remind all the East Coasters that Monday night on WGTW, XPW's Monday Nightmare, and starting this Friday night at 2 a.m., and every Friday night until XPW presents Hostile Takeover on Saturday night, August the 31st, from the XPW Arena, XPW presents No Sleep Till Philly. And for the LA fans, that's all the time we have this week on XPW TV. We'll see you right here next week, same extreme time, same extreme channel.